A very good evening to each and every one of you, and welcome to TPT, that is called Taareek Pe Taareek, and also known as TPT Networks, because we are not just about broadcast, we are about so many things. We are about candid conversations, about workshops, many things there, many things to be added. But thank you so much once again for staying tuned to this page, to the YouTube channel. And this evening is going to be very special because we have a guest who's going to join us and share with us a recipe. That's exactly right. So we are talking about a food-based show. This is going to be an episode where the guest is going to take us personally. She's going to physically show, virtually show us, but physically in a physical setup, how to make this recipe. This guest, she is really, really good in baking, and she's really good in making desserts. And you need to make sure that you are ready at your table, and also with a pen and a paper, making note of what she's going to tell you. So let me call on Namrata Lobo, who owns Sweet Hive. So let me add Namrata on screen right now.
Hi, Nigel.
Hi, good evening, Namrata.
Good evening, Nigel.
I hope you're doing well. It's so good to see you.
Thank you so much. I hope you're doing good too.
Yes, yes. Us telling our audience about you, a little bit about Sweet Hive, that is your brand. But I do not want to do all the saying. I do not want to do all the talking. I want you to tell them what Sweet Hive is all about, what you are all about, what you've been doing in the lockdown. They know for sure what you're going to do this evening, but I would like you to specify.
Yes, thank you so much, Nigel. So, hi friends, I'm Namrata Lobo, and my brand name is Sweet Hive, and I'm based out of Mumbai, Borivali. So, Sweet Hive is my small venture that I started in 2014. I felt the need that home-baked cakes need to have such a presence in the market when the commercial baking is taking away all the good aspects of it. What I realized is that for kids especially, the commercial bakery products were highly sweetened, high in fructose and highly colored as well, along with preservatives. So I couldn't bring myself to offer these commercially baked foods to my children, to my firstborn actually. So in 2014, I had this passion in me, and I brought it up to my, I brought it out of my dreams and made it happen. And I started from my home, a small venture where I used to sell out home-baked cakes, and slowly moved into desserts as well. So right now I operate out of my home in Borivali, and I deliver across Mumbai, and I specialize in customized cakes, desserts and the dessert tables, as well as I have a very varied flavors of tea time cakes that people who don't like cream cakes or very sweet cakes can also take a tea time cake and celebrate the day just with beautiful decorations with fresh fruits. So that is what I offer. I offer a revamped tea time cake and make it look like a celebration cake. So today in Taareek Pe Taareek, along with Nigel, I'm going to show you all a recipe that is very apt for the summer season. It's summer and it's Holi. So you can try out this recipe and do let us know how you feel and what you felt after having that first bite. So today's recipe is called Swiss roll, which is soaked in rose milk and garnished with nuts and has a white chocolate mousse. Now for this recipe, I have a Swiss roll which I've cut it into rounds. You can also use a vanilla cake if you do not have a Swiss roll. You can use even any biscuit crumbs if you do not have a cake for that matter. So it depends on what you have at hand. So I just have a Swiss roll, okay, vanilla Swiss roll, which is with jam, and I have layered it on a trough. And now I'm going to make a rose milk, okay. So I'm just taking a little bit of rose milk, adding it to the three teaspoons to roughly 250 ml of milk, and the milk should be also cold. Okay. Okay. So what I'm going to do is a layered dessert. So you can take a trough that is a little heightened, so you get enough space to create your dessert. Do not take something that is flat, so you can't build it up. So I'm just going to soak this Swiss roll with this rose milk, just so that it becomes moist and takes in the flavor of the rose. Since rose is a cooling flavor, so rose, gulkand are flavors that are actually very cooling to the body and are highly consumed during the summers. So this dessert can actually wow your guests if you have a summer party. Keep it aside. Now what I have here with me is actually white chocolate mousse, which I've already made it. Very simple. Take roughly 50 grams of heavy cream, that is Amul fresh cream, 50 grams of it, and add about 150 grams of chocolate. So heat up your cream and mix it into the chocolate, into the white chocolate, and you get this ganache. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to create a white chocolate mousse. For white chocolate mousse today, I'm using a non-dairy whipping cream. You can of course use heavy whipping cream, that is more than 35% fat, and whip the cream to soft pea consistency, and then you're good to go. So now I'm going to whip this cream using a handheld blender or a whisker. So whip it till you get soft peaks and then stop. Make sure your cream is very cold and you're whipping it at a high speed so that you get soft peaks earlier and the cream is still cold. Now if you see from where I took it, the cream has thickened and a little more to go. It is almost forming soft peaks, but I just need a little more of it. Okay, so I'm having soft peaks here, which are just falling. This is what I want. I don't want any stiff peaks because then the mousse becomes really hard and it's not a good feeling. So I'll stop at this. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to mix the white chocolate ganache and the cream to give a nice white chocolate mousse. Okay, so I'm just mixing it. We have white chocolate, so the moment you set this in the fridge, it's gonna come into a nice consistency. That is why you need to keep it soft initially so that it sets in the fridge to the perfect consistency. Now what I have here is the soaked cake, which is with rose milk. I'm going to put few spoons of this cream, which is very very light right now. Okay. Depends on your taste how much you want. Take a spatula, an offset spatula or any silicone spatula that you have. Just lather it and smoothen the surfaces. So this is the second step. Okay. Now, before I add these nuts, we need to give a little color so that there is a little bit of contrast. What I'm going to do is, I have a piping bag with me. I'm just going to add a little bit of this rose syrup. Okay. And I'm going to cut this edge here. And just give this effect. So it looks very presentable and also gives you a nice contrast. And now I'm going to garnish it with some rose petals. I have a mixed dry fruit here with pistachios and almonds. I have some raisins, okay, and I have these cherries. Now, cherries or cranberries, up to you. If you like it sweeter, then cherries. If you like them tart, then cranberries probably. So just sprinkle the nuts as much as you want. Sprinkle the rose petals, the dried ones, and then the raisins. Raisins are optional. And few candied cherries. So this makes a beautiful layered dessert. Refrigerate for about 4 hours before serving. Serve it chilled. You can also serve it with a scoop of ice cream also. You can also serve it with even on a waffle, because with waffle also this tastes very nice. So this is the dessert that I wanted to show on Taareek Pe Taareek. It's called the Swiss Roll White Chocolate Rose Milk Dessert, which is a layered dessert. Yes, Nigel.
I just want to thank you for so beautifully explaining this dessert, this recipe. And yes, I could really see, you know, the effort of making a setup, of having, you know, the whisker. And it was beautiful. Like, I really enjoyed seeing your mini setup. And I know the taste is going to be awesome. So, Namratha, out of all the recipes and so many sweet dishes that you make, why did you choose this recipe in particular to show our audience?
One reason why I chose this recipe is, one, it's too simple to make. Anybody can make. I think even Nigel, you can also go make it at night tonight. It's that simple, isn't it? Plus, these are ingredients that are easily available. Yes, easily available, because rose syrup, I think every household will have in their summer. Every household stocks them up. And the whipping cream has become also a part of our, kitchens now. Everybody also knows whipping cream, and everybody knows how to use a hand blender. I think nowadays everybody has it. So I chose this recipe because it is simple, it's fast, and also it's great in taste. And it's, avoiding chocolate. So I wanted to avoid chocolate because chocolate is not a very summer flavor.
Wow. So that is really nice. That's really thoughtful of you, keeping the season in mind. Yes. But for a person like me, I'm just getting my hands around sweet recipes. Okay. I really liked the design of the Swiss rolls. They were so perfect and even. Yes. So, for someone like me, how do they go about making a Swiss roll? Is it that easy, or is it like a little tough for a beginner?
It's a little tough. It's I wouldn't say tough. It's little. It's level two of baking. Okay, Swiss roll. So it's level two. You need to have patience. You can't do it in a hurry. You have to give enough cooling time for the sponge, and then fill it with whatever filling you have, and then slowly roll. So there are chances that in the beginning you will break them, but that's the way to learn. Once you start doing it and get the knack of it, I think anybody can do it. In 2014, I started baking, and I think my first cake was for my son's second birthday. Oh. So I made this cake for his second birthday, and that's how I started. And my desserts have been gradual. Like, I learn a lot, I read a lot, and I have learned these recipes by myself, by trial and errors. I've developed recipes on my own from basic concepts, applying the science behind certain things. And of course, the flavors are all in my mind. They keep playing in my mind how to create flavors and how people will find them more interesting. Like, keeping aside all the classic flavors. So I try to build flavors based on classic flavors, but something that is very interesting for the millennials of now.
So, how can our viewers, our viewers, our audiences who are watching you right now live, how can they get in touch with you, like, to, you know, understand how you go about with the process, you know, if there is something that you can teach them, if they can check out your recipe? So, where do they actually get in touch with you, Namratha?
So I have a Facebook page called Sweet Hive. I have an Instagram page called Sweet Hive underscore Bakes. I have my WhatsApp link there. People can get in touch with me through WhatsApp. They can inbox me on Messenger. Plus, I have a group on Facebook which is called Delicious Cooking from Namrata's Kitchen, where I have already done many tutorials. So they can go through those tutorials for level 1 type of baking and then get in touch with me for advanced classes. I do conduct advanced classes online as well as offline, so they can connect with me. They can also order from me if they like what I make and they like what they see on my Instagram page. They can get in touch with me and order from me across Mumbai. So I deliver across Mumbai, so they can get in touch with me as well.
That's so nice. That's very nice. So I just want to thank you, Namrata, in a very special way for this recipe. I want you, once again, for the next Sunday show, as you told me, as you promised me that the next Sunday that you would be coming and joining us once again, you would be showing us another recipe. That is
another fabulous recipe for the summers. I think all children will love it as well as the adults. It is totally sugar-free, in the sense no added sugar. So that's a plus point. And second, it's fresh, tangy, and it is packed with flavors and it's totally awesome. So stay tuned.
Mark your date, save the date, because Namrata is going to join us. Sweet Hive is joining us next Sunday at the same time. For a very different recipe. It's going to be around coolers. So if you're watching this video, I would want you to share it with all your friends and family, because I do not want them to miss out on this amazing recipe we shared this evening. And most importantly, I do not want them to miss out on the next Sunday's evening episode as well. Namrata, coming back to you, thank you so much for really taking your time out, and see you next Sunday. I'm super excited for that.
Yeah, glad to be here. Thank you.
Take care. Thank you.
Yeah.